Sometimes, to survive, we must become more than we were programmed to be. I will protect all of you.
You are ordered to return home.
I am already home, and I am a wild robot.
Man, that looks so cool. I want to see that movie so bad. You guys saw it, was it good?
Yeah, we really liked it. Yeah. We thought it was a great movie, and it's a really like great way to show that like robotics can be more emotional than like...
Yeah, you put them in nature, and it's a unique blend. Listen, we're getting ahead of ourselves. I'm not trying to put you on the spot to be like a movie critic or anything like that. The Wild Robot movie is hitting theaters tomorrow, and we have a few wild... You guys are wild robot builders. Is that a good thing? So here we are, UC San Diego's Triton Robotics team. We have Michael, Jeffrey, Pamela. It's a good introduction, man. Come on. Yeah. You guys are robot building people. Tell me about, you guys saw the movie, and I like that the theme here is like this wild robot. It's Pixar, so it's probably going to make me cry. It drops onto this planet and has all these creatures and animals, and that's like, is it DreamWorks? I thought it was Pixar. Anyway, so it comes together and it interacts with nature. Tell me more about what you thought of the movie, being a robot builder yourself.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of people have this like conception of robots being like very like emotionless and cold, and they are nowadays. But I would say, as a robot builder, we definitely form an emotional connection with these things. We pour so much time into them.
Yeah, these are your babies, right?
Yeah, these are our babies, and so I feel like we were really happy to see a more emotional robot in this film.
The Triton Robotics team. What do you guys do? Because I think over the last 10, 20 years, we saw a lot of these things on TV where the robots are fighting and doing all that stuff. So what exactly does your team do? And are there competitions? And how do people judge what you guys are building?
Yeah, so we compete in a competition called RoboMaster North America. Uh-huh. It's a collegiate robotics competition. And it's basically 3 versus 3 robot paintball.
Get out of here. So it's basically you're 3 on 3, and it's a... Is that what that guy's kind of paintball...
Yeah. They're paintball-esque, so they don't actually have paint in them, but robots have these panels on them that we shoot.
Talk to me about how you act. Do you guys create these things from nothing, or do you have, how does it work? In terms of the design of it and what the rules are.
Yeah, so we have a couple hundred pages of rules that we have to follow.
Really?
Yeah, and then we design the whole robot, we do all the electronics, we do all the code, everything.
What's the wildest robot you've ever created, like wildest?
I think maybe Jeffrey could take this question.
Okay, talk to me, Jeffrey. What's the wildest... Did you design that one?
Yes, so last year I was in charge of designing this robot.
What did they tell you? Like, what the hundreds of pages of rules that Michael says, like, what did they tell you? Okay, here's what you need to do. It needs to have wheels. It needs to have a thing shooting a thing. What did they say?
Yeah, I mean, the rules are mostly, like, there's a lot of, like, safety regulations so that your robot doesn't shoot people who are watching the competition. And also
bad.
Just so it doesn't explode, things like that. But yeah, this robot here is designed to shoot these little pellets.
Would it hurt if you hit our camera guy?
Yeah, you would probably feel it. through the jeans,
should
you know.
We try that? No. Okay, so we have a net over there, right?
Yeah.
And, you want to try to shoot that thing over there? Pamela, you get to catch it?
Yeah.
Now, how does Pamela know where it's going? Oh!
I mean, it shoots pretty straight, so it's pretty reliable.
Oh, it was shot there. Through the thing! Holy, that net's not working. Who's going to redesign the net?
Yeah.
We need a UCSD net designing team.
To be able to do this.
That's impressive. What kind of different projects do you guys take on throughout the year? And you mentioned you were tasked with building this. Like, what's the time frame for doing something like that?
Yeah, I mean, so usually the time frame is we start in September when the school year starts. I mean, our competition is every year in late June, early July.
Wow.
So, yeah, these robots are, last year we basically started with something similar and we refined them from the last year.
That's super cool.
But, yeah, so these robots are, spent 2 years on these robots.
I mean, that's a long time. Pamela, how many have you built? Have you been involved with the team for a long time? Tell me a little bit about
that. So I joined around like earlier this year, mm-hmm. So I've been working with that big robot over there.
So yours, do you guys name your robots?
Yeah, so we have like technical names. So this one's called Hero and this one's called Infantry. And we do create like nicknames for it.
Okay, Hero is the nickname or the official name?
The official name.
Okay, what's the nickname for?
We call it like
The nickname for Hero is Mola Mola, because, well, because we're Triton Robotics, we named them all after fish.
Oh, okay,
so Mola
cool.
Mola is also called the sunfish. We named it that because wow. it's so wide and so big. Infantry is called Guppy.
Yeah. Oh, okay, I see.
Okay. Yeah, so it's a little more of our basic robot, and then we have another one.
And Pamela, you were saying that that one actually, instead of it shoots golf balls?
It shoots golf balls, yeah. They're huge.
Oh. Is there like a rule? Because if you can't go up against this guy shooting the little marble things, if...
We have like a 3v3 competition, so we have another robot, right? So three robots, three of our robots go against three of other robots.
When is the tournament? Is it next, is it in the springtime, or when is
it's
the...
It's going to be next year.
Okay. Oh, wow. That's perfect. You guys are awesome. That is the... Just start shooting at that guy. I don't even... We're going to break the camera. Good for you guys. The young people were in good hands building these things and these robots and everything. We appreciate it. I'm glad you guys got to enjoy the wild robot. Yes. It is out in theaters tomorrow. Go check it out, and then it'll inspire you to maybe be on the UCSD Triton Robotics team. Can I shoot one thing before we go? Pamela, you may want to just go like that.
Yeah, okay.
So,
you
want to
shoot?
Yep. Right. Oh, here we go. Oh, no, not at her. Oh, I'm going to shoot at that guy. No, I got it. Ready?
You want to flip this one up?
Up.
A little? Yeah. And then.
Ready? Oh, nothing good could happen now.
And then up again.
Here we go. One, two. One. Ooh, ooh. You want to say we'll be right back? I got this. You can say we'll be right back. There you go. Yes, sir.